Hello everyone, in this tutorial we will learn how we can create a curved surface or a solid with a curved surface in COMSOL Multiphysics. This could be very useful if you want to model a realistic device because generally the surface is rough for any device, it is not perfectly smooth. So there are many ways you can do that, but I will show you a method using parametric surface feature which you can use to create a curved surface or a rough surface. So at first I will just create a 3D component so that we can create a 3D feature, and then in the geometry I'll go here, and in the more primitives I'll click on parametric surface. Now I have a expression here which I will plug in, but here in the first parameter and the second parameter we have S1 and S2 by default. So in the expression I don't want to change the X and Y value, those are the inputs, and then we'll calculate Z, so the surface will fluctuate its value along the Z direction. So for X we have S1 and Y we have S2, and in the Z I have an expression that I don't want to waste my time, so I'll just copy it. You can use any expression and check how the result comes. So I have this expression. When I click on build, you will know how it looks. So I will explain once again. So we have the first parameter with a range 0 to 1, second parameter 0 to 1, and then these are the xy's, and we calculate z which is a function of s1 and s2, and these are combination of sine and cos just to simulate a rough surface. This is not actually rough, but a kind of rough surface at a macro level. So when I click on bin selected, you see that we have a nice surface which is kind of a rough surface. Now depending on the terms you add, so let's say I add here maybe 700, click on bin selected, we have different surface. So let me just type 7, and we have this nice surface. You can add any other term like a log term or something like that and get your own surface if you wish to. So you might have seen that in the parametric surface I am getting a warning related to the relative error. So one quick way to fix this warning, you can just go on to the advanced settings and you can set the relative tolerance to some low value. I'll just set it to 0.03 and see if it works. So when I click on build all, I have this surface and I don't have an error right now. So if we increase this to 70 and click on build all object, I have this nice surface. You can always vary the surface parameter and see how it works. You can add more terms if you wish to. And instead of 100, if I make this to 30, you see that we have a very complicated surface. Instead of 30, maybe I'll add 50. That's too much. I'll just make it 60. Yeah. So okay, so we have the parametric surface. Now what is the next step? So the next step is I will create a block. So click on the block, and for the block I'll just keep the width and depth to 1 and height to 0.1 and click on build selected. So I have a block along with the parametric surface. Now it is convenient to shift the position so that it will be useful for me to work. So we have the surface and the solid. So the next step, I will use the sweep feature. So I'll go on to sweep. Now I have to select face to sweep and edge to follow. So the face is this, and turn on the edge to follow and click here. Now we don't have to change much settings. Click on build selected, and we have a nice surface, but the solid, it's still attached to it. So we can do is we can just move it a bit, maybe 0.09, and we have a nice surface. I think 0.9 is too much. I'll just make it 0.8 or 7. Yeah, I think now it's fine. So we have this solid block with a parametric surface and flat on the other side. If you want to make a solid which is clean and you don't want to mess with all these features, what you can do is just position this somewhere else, maybe something like this. This may not be the best way, but I do it this way. Just go on to difference. Now click on object. Click on object to subtract here. And click on build all object. Now click on zoom extends. So now we have a nice rough surface on both sides. So if you want to make one of the surface flat, you can always add a block at one side, and you can have the rough surface, or you can have the both surface if you wish. So depending on the equation you put, you will have different rough surface which then you can use for your model. I think this tutorial was useful to you, and if it did, do give a like and also follow this channel. You can also check out my courses in the description. Thank you for watching and have a nice day ahead.